I welcome all of you for coming for today's event. So thank you for coming and encouraging all these young people. Now you can see this young boy in a blue shirt. He's just 12 years old child, I would just say that. And he is one of the speakers today. And we are offering a class on Valmiki Ramayana, as many of you know, every Saturday morning. And when I see Valmiki Ramayana book, I get scared by the looks of it. And this boy is attending that class every Sunday morning, Valmiki Ramayana, just imagine. So today we have with us two of them you've seen before, Dr. Vinesh Sharma from IIT Roorkee. He's a professor at IIT Roorkee, professor of management. And there's a lot to talk about him, but as we have kind of agreed informally in this forum, we want to talk less about people, we want to talk more about Paramatma as much as possible. So we avoid some long introductions. So then we have Dr. Tanmay Chakravarthiji. He is by profession a chemical engineer, did PhD in chemical engineering, and he's heading Gaudium at in Houston for some 25 years. So he's in Houston, so I have an opportunity, honor to meet him and learn from him many times. And then I want to welcome Sri Saithi Chaturvedi, whom you have heard here on this forum. So he's by profession chartered accountant, but he lives in Dubai. And he's a very good singer, very good musician, Shastri Sangeet, Vagraga Bhav, and Gugyan. So these three individuals will be kind of the participants. I think evaluation is not the right word, but for lack of better words, I'm using that. So what I've requested them that, you know, they are young people. We want to encourage them at this forum. They are our future, our days are numbered. So I count every new day as a new day in my life, you know. So one extra day I'm getting from Bhagwanji. So tomorrow I may not see. So I think these young children have to carry forward our mission. So with that, unless anybody has any question for me, I will transfer the control to Professor Vinesh Sharma, and he will run the proceedings now onwards. And I may come at the end if there's any need to close today's session. So merely, if you have any question, anybody has anything for me?
I will just say my regard to Omji for his dedication and for his initiative to do all these. And we appreciate this very much because we also try to do the same thing, to inculcate the values of Sanatana Dharma in our new generation. We have Vedic school, heritage school, Hindi school in our temple. So we know the value of this, and we really appreciate the things that Omji has been doing for last many years. Thank you.
Tanmay said that, let me just kind of tell you that we did talk about Ramchaitmanthan. So first 2 years we did Ramchaitmanthan in another temple. After that, we have been doing every year Ramchaitmanthan in Gaudium Math temple with the blessings and support of Tanmayji. Of course, this year, you know, thanks to current situation, we got into this online format. But look what this online has done. Now, we were doing Manthan like once a year, the totally local Estonians will get together. Now we are doing every week, and now we are doing even more than 1 week in some events in the middle of it. So how it has grown up. So I think the root, of course, is, you know, Tanmay, as you know very well, he is always supported that. So thank you for that support and that look, that seed that you have supported, how it is blossoming. So we already have 47 people right now listening to us on Zoom. and it is live on YouTube, and I don't know how many people are on YouTube. So thanks, so kind of you. So now I think without much, we already took 10 minutes. I will request Professor Vinay Sharma to take over, and I will share.
Jai Sri Ram, Hare Krishna.
Yes.
So only two things for the participants. At the 8th minute, I'll just put a note on chat box that 8th minute has passed. Or simply 8th minute. And 10th minute, I'll request host, if someone is going beyond, to mute the speaker. So please don't take it otherwise. It's just to keep up the time. And if you are keeping it, so that is the most wonderful thing. At the end of your talk, amongst three of us would be asking a question, and you have to answer that within 1 minute. So that total 11 minutes per speaker. And then at the end of the talk of the seventh speaker, when the individual question is over, so one common question would be floated, and in your own sequence, you would be answering that question within 1 minute each. So another 7 minutes for that answer, basically. So one simple question would be asked, and everyone would be answering the same question. So that is the only three things for you to listen, and then let's start. So I'll be inviting people in the order which it is already decided. So I'll first be inviting Miss Aparna Singh for her talk, and Aparna ji, please go ahead.
Thank you so much, sir, and a very good evening to everyone over here. Hare Ram, Hare Krishna to everyone. My heartfelt veneration to all elders here, and my regards to all my fellows. Today, I'm pleased that I'm given an opportunity that I should discuss and compare and contrast, though I am nobody to compare and contrast the iconic historical figures of Sanatan Dharma, the Lord Ram and the Lord Krishna. But yes, I would like to throw some light on what I have perceived in my life through my learnings, through my experiences, through my idea of these figures, how I perceive them as leaders, as strategic beings, as more so human beings. So I will just try to, as per my own capacity, try to put up a few details regarding what I have garnered the idea about the characters, say the historical figures of Lord Ram and Lord Krishna. But I would request, sir, moderator, sir, to kindly allow me to share a screen so that I can just share a few tips and bits of my presentation for a smooth flow.
Yeah, as per your choice, but please do it within 10 minutes, the allotted time.
Yeah. I tried keeping time.
So your time has started, and
So as far as Lord Ram and Lord Krishna is considered, both are the historical figures, not the mythological figures as the popular perception had been. But now the perception has changed, and people like us who are researching more into the details of these iconic figures have found out that no, they are more of historical ones. And the characterization, the portrayal of these figures in the various narratives of Sanatan Dharma, well, it be Ramayana by Valmiki ji or Ramcharitmanas by Tulsidas ji for Lord Ram, or Srimad Bhagavad Gita, or Vishnu Puran, or similar narratives and scriptures for Lord Krishna, it has been found that there is some stark similarities and some stark dissimilarities also in the portrayal of both the characters. First, similarity-wise, if we see that they are the Poorna avatars of Lord Vishnu, and they are the ones who belong to royal lineage, and they have portrayed some normative behaviors that is expected out of social context they are value-based leaders, ethical leaders, they are socially concerned people who have actually not only taken care of their subjects, but also challenged the popular, discontorted context of their time. So these figures have stark similarities, but as far as today's topic is about comparison, it's the Ram and Krishna, a comparative analysis. So I will be trying to put up light in the perspective of strategic management area, like what is strategies, what values, what actions, what we have seen and felt about both the figures, both the legendary figures of our Hindu or Sanatan Dharmic parampara. So starting with, I would like to share some excerpts from my own book. This book is Management by Dashavataram. And I would like to share a few details about Lord Ram. I hope the screen is, everyone can visualize the screen.
Yes.
Okay, sir. So I start with Lord Ram. Lord Ramchandra, I will be talking in the context of Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran because that is the book I have researched into. I have a greater detail about the Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran, which is a Puran, one of the most famous Puran. It's called the incarnation of Lord Vishnu itself in the literary form, and it has been composed by sage Ved Vyasji, who has composed the Mahabharata himself. So in that context, I'll be talking. And what is mentioned about Lord Ram there? Starting with Lord Ram, I would like to show a slide of mine, which I have presented for today's topic. As we all know, the Lord Ram, the Prince of Ayodhya, has appeared in Tveta Yuga, and he is highly worshipped avatar in Sanatana Dharma. And he is regarded as an ideal hero. Like he is stated as one of the most popular deity of Sanatana Dharma. And we all are aware of this story, so no need to discuss the story. But the story has been discussed in detail in the canto, or you say the book 9, in discourses 10 and 11 of Srimad Bhagavat Mahapuran as Sri Ramchandra's pastime. And in that it has been mentioned that Ramchandra is mostly a values-based leader. He is a conformist in nature who has actually laid much stress on ethics, values and morality. So if we see, by contrast, Lord Krishna is non-conformist leader. He is said to be a contingency-based, situational leadership-based leader. Because when we see the story of Ram and the various circumstances in which he had been taking decisions, strategic decisions for his own people, like for his father, mother, like parents, for his spouse, for his brothers, or for his Sena, Vanar Sena, or for his subjects at large in Ayodhya. Everywhere we see that he has conformed to the societal norms. He has actually taken to the highest of the Maryada values. That's why he is called Maryada Purushottam. But when we talk about Lord Krishna, we see that he is a non-conformist being, because he said whatever the situation will warrant, whichever way the situation will warrant, then I will take decisions accordingly. So Lord Krishna, though he was also of royal lineage, he came from Mathura and later is the Prince of Mathura and later became the King of Dwarka. And he was the eighth son of Devaki and Vasudev. Though his time period is different, he appeared in Dwapar Yuga and is often depicted as a very playful personality with very mischievous spirit. And he has tried in his whole pastimes in childhood, tried defeating various evil forces. This was not the case with Rama. He in the childhood, he had got very less opportunity compared to Lord Krishna to fight the evil forces. But wherever he got, in his adulthood, wherever he got the opportunity, he tried his level best to portray the best possible values of taking decisions. So, this way we see that as we say, Sri Ramachandra's father, Maharana Bhavaya Darunam, Ramji is the person who has shown us the servant leadership model, the path goal leadership model, and the various models like walking. And in his stories, we can see there are scenarios of logistics management. There are scenarios of materials management. His when he is organizing his sena and actually trying to conquer Ravan and defeat Ravan, he's doing all that. But in Krishna's sense, we have seen situational leadership, contingency-based leadership, path goal leadership. Though there is also management by walking around, but then we see that Krishna Bhagwan, he has been doing it with the incremental logic. Logicalism, which is called incremental logicalism. So, in Lord Ramchandra, you can see here, he has shown cultural intelligence, theory of logical incrementalism, resource-based view, integrated organizational culture and information flow management. You can see from the slide itself, these are the various strategies that have been adopted by Lord Rama. As far as Lord Krishna is concerned, the various strategies that were adopted by him were
Aparna ji, your time is up. I will request now Sri Sahitya Chaturvedi ji to ask his question.
Arpana ji, I think you have given a very good explanation in your presentation, and we appreciate that the subject you picked up. The subject what you picked up is really a matter of appreciation and research work. I would like to have a simple question. You have given the comparatives between Ram and Krishna, the strategic style. Can you give one similarity between the strategies adopted by Krishna and Ram?
Both the characters are very people oriented. So whatever decisions, strategic decisions they took, they showed the strategy of people management, and of course the values, they kept some values as the normative behavior. So these values based management and the transformational leadership, because they tried to transform the society through their actions. So these strategies were adopted uniformly by both the characters, I think.
Thank you so much, Aparna, for keeping up your talk within time very much and answering beautifully. Thanks.
Thank you, sir.
Now I invite Akarsh to please start his talk. Akarsh, welcome to this discussion forum, and we are happy to have you with us. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir. Namaste everyone. My name is Akarsh Bansal and I am 13 years old. The topic for my presentation is similarities and differences between Rama and Krishna. I will be discussing who was Lord Rama, who was Lord Krishna, similarities between Rama and Krishna, differences between Rama and Krishna, conclusion, who was more powerful, and summary. Who was Lord Rama? Lord Rama was the seventh avatar of Lord Vishnu. Rama's blue skin symbolizes the infinite expanse of blue sky and blue ocean, and the purity of the gods. Sometimes the palms and soles of the feet of gods and goddesses are red or pink, which is a sign of a god. This is the case with Lord Rama, from which many people had the realization of him being a god. Who was Lord Krishna? Lord Krishna is the eighth avatar of Lord Vishnu. Krishna is considered to be a warrior, hero, teacher, and philosopher by Hindus. It is believed that he had been born to free the earth from all evil, demolish adharma, and to spread dharma and moral values all over the world. Similarities. Both incarnations of Vishnu could be, both are incarnations of Lord Vishnu. Both came to earth to destroy adharma. Both were in the category of a supreme person. Both are Hindu gods. Both had the same body color of a mid-light blue. Both were teachers of dharma. Both are respected and worshipped in Hindu religion. Both Rama and Krishna show extreme selflessness when it comes to material possessions. Differences. Lord Krishna was born in Mathura. On the other hand, Rama was born in Ayodhya. Krishna belongs to the lunar dynasty. In contrast, Rama belongs to the solar dynasty. Krishna had 8 wives. Meanwhile, Rama had only 1 wife. Bali killed Krishna in his next birth. Subsequently, Rama killed Bali. Krishna was born in a jail. However, Rama was born in a palace. Krishna was born at midnight, whereas Rama was born during midday. Krishna was born on Ashtami. Alternatively, Rama was born on Navami. Krishna was born in Dwapar Yug. On the other hand, Rama was born in Treta Yug. Krishna went to the forest to see his cousins who were destined to live there for 12 years. Rama had to go to the forest for 14 years. Krishna made his own interpretation of dharma and twisted it on many occasions during the war. Meanwhile, Rama always followed dharma. Krishna was the charioteer to Arjuna. However, Rama fought the war himself to kill Ravana. Krishna's weapon is the Sudarshan Chakra. Meanwhile, Rama's weapon is a bow and arrow. Krishna was never the king, but always the kingmaker, whereas Rama lived the king and ruled the kingdom. Krishna is the youngest and Balrama, the avatar of Sheshnag, is his elder brother. Rama is the eldest. Lakshman, an avatar of Sheshnag, was his younger brother. Conclusion. Who was more powerful? They both are incarnations of Lord Narayana, or widely known as Lord Vishnu. As well as there is no difference between Lakshmana and Balrama, they both are incarnations of Adishesha, who is the bed of Lord Vishnu. Both had near equal powers and chivalry because they both were incarnation of Vishnu in his human form, and both possessed nearly same qualities of heart and body. Summary. To conclude my presentation, I would like to sing a short stanza of my bhajan. Jag mein sundar hai do naam, chahe Krishna ka ho ya Ram. Bolo Ram, 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 bolo Sham, Sham, Sham. Thank you, and I hope you enjoyed.
Beautiful. It was a wonderful presentation. Akash, so nice to hear your voice, and you know the bhav is so beautiful, so much of innocence, and you have deciphered every single bit of at least I did not know so many things about Sri Ram and Sri Krishna actually. Thank you so much.
Can I take just 1 second?
Sure.
I just want to add, Akash is a 13 years old young boy. He lives in UK, and I think you were born there. You were born in UK, Akash?
Yes.
So he was born and raised in UK. So I think that's something we should all think about.
Absolutely.
Next Tuesday, when we are going to sing bhajans on Lord Krishna, he will be one of the singers. All done yet. So,
excellent.
So you want to listen to him singing? Excellent. Come here on Tuesday. All right. Sorry. Thank
excellent.
You.
Excellent.
Thank so, you.
Now I invite Sri Chakravarti ji to ask his question. To Akash, please.
Yes, Adarsh, thank you for beautiful presentation, as I'll recognize. And I'm very happy to see, born in UK, you are keeping up with the Vedic heritage.
Thank you.
Thanks to your parents, I must say, and you should recognize that. My question will be from Lord Ram and Lord Krishna, as you have compared them and found similarities. What is your take for your life from each of them?
Lord Ram was sent to the forest from Kekai, and he had to adapt to that environment. And from that, I take that even if you have to move or go to a different environment or different schools, such a few years ago I had to change from primary school to secondary school, so I had to adapt, and I think I've done that really well, and Ishwar ki kripa. And for Krishna ji, he had lots of evil spirits attacking him when he was quite young, and in normal life you could relate this as things or people pushing you down, that you need to stay up and keep fighting, and one day you will win.
Thank you
Akash, beautiful answer. Thank you so much. So now it's time for Supriti to initiate her talk. So I invite Supriti, please go ahead.
Namaste everyone. I'm Supriti Hegde from Bangalore. Today, I feel very happy to express about how Lord Krishna makes our life so beautiful. Before starting, I would like to take blessings from all the dignitaries who are hearing to me. Lord Krishna, the name itself carries the greatest sense of divinity. And Lord Krishna Lord Krishna makes our life guided at every moment, like a guru, as a philosopher, or as a friend in the form of Bhagavad Gita. So, Lord Krishna, son of Devaki and Vasudeva, was brought up by Yashodha Maya and Nanda Maharaj in Vrindavan. We always notice that from his childhood, he was he killed so many demons, and he always brought peace and harmony. And this shows us that even we should always kill the negativity around us and spread peace and harmony. But before doing that, we should also kill the negativity in ourselves. So now the question arises how to do so. The answer is the only Bhagavad Gita. In Bhagavad Gita, we do find 700 plus shlokas that take us to the path of knowledge, karma, and moksha. Now I have picked a few verses that from Bhagavad Gita that have greatly influenced the youth, including me. Bhagavad Gita is one of such manuals for human life, which was gifted by Lord Krishna to the whole humankind. Now I would like to start with what was Bhagavad Gita exactly. Bhagavad Gita was first narrated to Surya Bhagavan by Lord Krishna. Bhagavad Gita can be said as a compact collection of all Vedas and Upanishads. Lord Krishna narrates it to Arjuna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra when Arjuna says that he just keeps his weapons, and he says that he could live happily even begging, but couldn't survive by killing his own grandfather, teacher, and his siblings. Well, then Lord Krishna does say him that it is not the way. And now, I would like to explain a verse from the second adhyaya, which is Sankhya Yoga, wherein Lord Krishna speaks about who is a knowledgeable person and how a knowledgeable person controls his senses. Yada samharate chayam kurmonganiva sarvashaha indriyani indriyarthebhyaha tasya prajna pratishthita. Now, the meaning is, one who is able to withdraw his senses from the sense objects as a tortoise draws its limbs within the shell is to be understood as a knowledgeable person. Well, at the beginning, even I couldn't understand this. Well, after gradually reading it for 5 to 6 times, I could understand the depth of it and understood that the senses that were mentioned here were the Arishadvarga, which is Kama, Krodha, Moha, Mada, Matsara, and Lobha. We can compare these 6 senses to 6 huge venomous serpents that are mostly a part of human life. So these 6 serpents, they always want to act freely and never want to get like restricted from what they want to do. So basically a knowledgeable person always controls these 6 huge serpents like a snake charmer. So, and by doing this, he does achieve a lot more than others who achieve much more lesser than him by not controlling these 6 senses. The second verse that I would like to explain to you all is this most venomous serpent that can be called as Krodha. Krodhat bhari sammoha, sammohat smriti bhramaha. Smriti bhramshat buddhinasho, buddhinashat pranashyati. From anger, delusion arises. And from delusion, confusion of memory, or we can also say that we lose all the knowledge at that moment. When memory is lost, intelligence is also lost with it. And when intelligence is lost, we again fall into the world of foolishness. This is one of such verses from Bhagavad Gita that can bring great change in the youth. So even me, after personally understanding and reading this verse, I could see great changes in me. And also by these changes, I could also feel the change in my surrounding. And I promise you that if every person understands and inculcates this one shloka in their life, they can see a better place than Swarga, what they would have dreamt of. Now, the third important character a person should inculcate in his life is to be happy or to be satisfied. In the fourth adhyaya, which is Jnana Yoga, there is a method taught or a solution given to be happy in your life. Yatra chalabha santushtho dvandvatito vimatsaraha samasiddhava siddhaucha kritvapina nibhadyate. He who is satisfied with his own hard-earned gain is free from confusion. He also compares success and failure as equal. And how can he be entangled in the world of foolishness? Now, we do feel that what can be the connection of this shloka with the youth? Of course, what I feel is whenever we are reading such great epic books like Mahabharata, Ramayana or Gita, we should always notice that there is always a hidden meaning in these shlokas or a moral. Lord Krishna here is mentioning 3 major morals, which is we should work honestly and be happy with what we earn out of our honest work. And the second one is that we should always treat the success and failure the same as we would have worked honestly, and that is what is bringing us what we get now. And when we treat both success and failure the same, what can make us foolish? People around us do try to manipulate with our emotions over our work, but when we are stable with our sense, nothing can confuse us. The fourth and the final shloka is all about punya you have got by reading, hearing or analyzing the Gita. Shraddhavanana suyascha shrunyadapi yo naraha sopi mukta shubham lokan prapnu punya karmana. One who listens to Gita with faith becomes free from all sinful actions. Now, I thank Omji for giving us this opportunity to share thoughts about Lord Rama and Krishna. I do feel very proud to speak in front of all the dignitaries who can be called as personification of knowledge. Again, with blessings of Lord Rama and Krishna, I would like to thank you all for giving me this opportunity and encouraging us to speak about Lord Rama and Krishna. Thank you.
Beautifully spoken, Sukanya. So nice to hear. It's a wonderful, wonderful kind of.
Sir, Supriti.
Oh, sorry, Supriti. Sorry. Sukanya is your mother's name. I apologize. Yeah, sorry. So, but sir wants to speak about you.
Where is Rama? Why did you leave out Rama? I would have loved to hear your analysis of Sri Ram too.
My sister is giving an analysis.
Her sister is going to speak on Sri Ram, ma'am.
All right.
Just after her. Yeah. Just
great
after
job.
Her.
Great job. Sorry for intervening. I couldn't resist. I wanted to hear this young lady's views on Sri Rama, just as she describes Sri Krishna so well.
Yeah. Both of the sisters are presenting in this session today. Yeah. Sir, you would like to say something, sir?
Yeah, I in the beginning I said I'll just shut up and not speak. That's very difficult when we listen to young kids like this. You know, we are doing a Valmiki Ramayana class and we have found a professor in Malaysia who is doing it. So I've been thinking about doing some Gita class, but I haven't found a teacher, so we didn't start. Now I found a teacher. So I will start Gita class sometime soon when our Suprati will be able to have time to come and teach us. So wonderful. So beautiful. God bless you, Vita.
Excellent. So I have one question for you, Supriti.
Yes,
I get confused when I think of Shri Krishna, doing his Leela as a friend, actually. So he first confuses and then he clarifies. So what is your take on this? What do you feel about it?
Sir, every time whenever he confuses someone, he does that with a particular purpose or something. So whenever at the first beginning, we can also see in Mahabharata that once when Arjuna says that he cannot lift weapon against his grandfather, he does say, I will, as he had promised earlier to the Mahabharata Yuddha, he does say that he wouldn't lift any weapon, and he promises that to Duryodhana also. And then in the battlefield, he does do that. He just takes off his chakra and he says, then when you can't do it, I'll do it myself then. So there, that is a purpose wherein he wants Arjuna to understand what is the exact need to kill his grandfather or to take the weapon against Adharma. So therefore, he tries to make him feel that, okay, this is not the way I am supposed to be. If Lord Krishna is taking the weapon, then it is going to be it won't be true it won't be good. So therefore he agrees to take his own weapons. So therefore he does that every time whenever Krishna confused Arjuna or any person for that matter, he did it with a purpose. And whenever he did that, every time the result was something good that came out of it.
Excellent. Thank you so much. So beautifully answered. Thank you. Now I invite Savitri to please come up and talk about Sri Ram, as ma'am just mentioned that, so both the sisters, they are presenting
namaste.
As counterparts. Yeah, namaste. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Shri Rama Rama Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasra Nama Tattulyam Rama Nama Varanam Jai Shri Ram. Good evening to all the dignitaries present in this webinar. I am Savitri Hegde from Bangalore. I am presently 16 years old. First and foremost, I would like to pranam to all of you. And I would like to thank Mr. Om Gupta Ji and Ram Charitmanas team for giving this great opportunity to speak about a commendable personality and glorify him, Lord Rama. So I have read Valmiki Ramayana and have analyzed it and have taken a topic of leadership. So I'll take on. The world where we live today is a modern world, and the era is a modern era where everything is westernized, modernized and mechanized. But still, there are few places which are fire lit from the warmth of bhakti and spirituality. And the people who are living with bhakti are leading an ascetic life. Hence, to lead us through such a path, we need a good leader. And I cannot think of a person more better, or we can say best, than Lord Rama. Leadership is the most essential resource of the modern period. And in today's world and present situation has led to the need of great leaders. John Quincy Adams once said that if your actions are inspiring people around you to do more, learn more, dream more, and become more, then you're a leader. And that's exactly the personality of Lord Rama. He not only inspired the people around him, but also made them dream more, do more, and learn more, which led to they becoming good and doing good deeds, which not only made their souls beautiful, but also their selves beautiful. So I came to notice that Lord Rama was not only a great king, an obedient son, a loving husband, and a caring brother, but what set him apart was his great leadership abilities. So I have pointed out some notes which I feel are very important to be noted for becoming a good leader. First and foremost trait for any successful leader should have is a clear vision. And Lord Rama had a very clear vision. Even though he knew that he was a lord, he did not show up that he was a lord. He acted as if he was a pretty normal human being. And when he lost Sita Mata, he did not do anything which showed up his divinity, but he led the army of Vanarasena and defeated Rakshasas and rescued Sita Mata. This clear vision is very important for the youth or the to be leaders, that is us. The second and important trait or ability is to organize the resources effectively. When Sri Ram left his kingdom, he had nothing. He was on barefoot, and the most prized possessions he had was Lord Sita Mata and Lakshmana and his Kodanda Dhanush. He was a prince who always walked on the rose bed, but now he was walking through the path which had stones, thorns, and many other things which might be a great suffering. But he came up with all difficulties which were on his way. But when he lost Sita Mata, one of his most prized possessions, it was one of the toughest moments. He cried, whined, and started searching for her everywhere. When he got to know that she was in Lanka, he had to get a great army to defeat Ravana. But what happened was being in Vanavasa, he couldn't ask anybody's help. So he chose Vanarasena. Even though he was son of one of the greatest kings, he did not ask any neighboring country's help. But what did he do? He saw something which nobody saw in Vanaras and took them as his companions, trained them to face enemies, and led them successfully and won the war. This is how a great leader should see something in somebody which nobody else sees. This is a very important trait to be noted. The third trait is to bear any kind of pain with patience. Lord Rama was a prince and a king to be, but we can say that he did not get thrown when he had to be thrown. He went through a lot of pain, but he came through all of it. There's a very beautiful Kannada poem that Innashtu Bekinna Hridayake Rama in Kannada. I will just say it. Kashtagala kodabeda yanalare Rama, kashta sahisuva sahane kodu nanage Rama, कष्ट सहे सुव सहने इन्नस्तु राम कष्ट सहे सुव सहने निन्नस्तु राम which means I don't Lord Rama I don't ask you to not give me any pain but I ask you to give me the strength to actually face the problem I ask you to give me the strength and patience to face the problems like the strength you had when you faced your problems a good leader is a person who doesn't do everything on his own but does the same thing through his companions so at the end yes this is all true but why do we need lord rama today more than ever before because lord rama is much more simply a name of a hindu god the beauty of lord rama lies in his character but not in his name lord rama can be simply described as a man who displays perfect moral values as well as a social behavior lord rama in lord vivekananda's words is the embodiment of truth and morality an ideal son ideal husband and above all a ideal king he is the symbol of victory of right over the evil lord rama characterizes how a man should fulfill his moral commitments and show strictly follow his limits so that his social order can be maintained it is precisely due to this factor that he is called the maryada purushottama a man of limits at the end right. I would like to say that ramayana is a story of a great ideal king who is now worshiped as a greatest deity his story is considered as an epic and bonds
right. your time is up Savitri. Now I would request Sri Chakravarti ji to ask his question to you.
Yes, I'm ready.
Thank you, Savitri ji. It is very, very wonderful to hear from you. And I wish I knew Kannada to understand your poem, but I got the message. And my question will be, in your view, what with you know you ask from Lord Ram if he has to come and give his darshan
his darshan itself is enough but I would love to have the kind of patience and that strength he actually had when he faced his problems I would like to live the way Lord Rama lived with all the morality the wisdom strength to face any kind of problem ideals and many things many much more because he lord rama is a perfect frame of a personality which anybody should inculcate in their lives to lead a better life so I would ask him to give the same personality as he owned to me so that I can live the way he did thank you
for the beautiful answer so be it you become a wonderful leader for your community and the nation
thank you
excellent so beautifully answered Savitri thank you so much beautiful talk thank you now I would invite Garima Singh to please initiate her talk Garima
Pranam everyone. Before starting, I would like to ask for your blessings. So I'll be speaking about the differences between Lord Ram and Lord Krishna. So without any delay, I would like to start. Lord Ram is believed to be and worshipped as the seventh incarnation of Lord Vishnu. He is particularly important to the Vaishnavism, tradition of Hinduism. whereas Lord Krishna is believed to be as the eighth avatar of Lord Vishnu. Well, both Lord Ram and Lord Krishna are incarnations of Lord Vishnu. There are still differences between both of them in their personalities. The era they were born in, well, Ramayana is about Treta Yuga, and which is considered as an innocent age. Lord Ram personifies the characteristics of an ideal person, which is also known as Purushottam. He was confined to follow moral obligations, which is why it is called as Maryada. Whereas Mahabharata is about Dwapar Yuga, which is considered slightly corrupt and darker age. Here, Lord Krishna played the role of path shower. If he wanted, he could have finished the entire Kurukshetra war in a single day. But Lord Krishna did not do so. Instead, he directed Pandavas so that they know what to do. The next is the approach towards life. Lord Ram was idealistic and was known as Maryada Purushottam. He was idle in every role played by him. The era he lived in believed in upholding the moral code or dharma, irrespective of all the consequences. Lord Krishna, on the other hand, was born in Dwapar Yuga. Around him, morality was already in decline. He knew the final consequences of all the events, yet he could not actively intervene. During Treta Yuga, two major yogas were introduced, Karma Yoga and Bhakti Yoga. As Lord Ram is a symbol of morality, through his deeds, he excellently managed to surpass the message of Karma Yoga. And devotees like Hanuman, Vibhishan, Sant Kabir, Tulsidas led to the evolution of Bhakti Yoga. Karma Yoga is the path of unselfish action. It teaches that a spiritual seeker should act according to dharma without being selfish or attached to personal consequences. However, in Dwapar Yuga, for the first time in history, Lord Krishna introduced the third yoga, that was Gyan Yoga, which emphasizes path of self-realization. The Gyan Yoga is a spiritual practice that pursues knowledge with questions such as, who am I, what am I, among others. The need for the establishment of Gyan Yoga was much needed as per Lord Krishna due to the decline of morality. Lord Krishna not only played the role of a strong and a smart strategist, but also guided his beloved devotees and bestowed his divine blessings on them. Lord Ram, who is regarded as one man woman, married and loved only one lady, that was Goddess Sita. Whereas in case of Lord Krishna, he didn't marry Radharani, despite the fact that she was his consort. Not only this, Lord Krishna had 8 principal queens. Further, he had to marry 16,100 women in a historical event, although it was done only in order to save the characteristic of those women who were kidnapped by Naraskara. That's all from my side. Thank you very much.
Excellently timed, precisely, basically. Thank you. So, now, Sri Chaturvedi ji would ask his question now.
Yeah, Garima, very precisely you have characterized. I will like to hear, or for the audience, that because you touched upon the lifestyle, yeah, that approach towards the life. So, the similar, what is your take home for the lifestyle from both the characters?
Sir, I think Lord Ram, as we have seen, he lived a very simple life. After he went to the forest life. Before that, although he lived a very royal life, but after that he became a very simple man. So I think simplicity is very important. And as we see Lord Krishna, I think he was also a very simple man, but I think he was an excellent leader. So I think these two traits I would like to take from these two great people.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Can I ask one question? Can I ask one question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If sir, we will ask questions in the end, basically, once we get over.
Okay. Can I put my opinion on it?
I request you to please hold till end, sir.
Okay.
Just two, three presenters are more there. Two more are there. So we will. Yeah. We'll come back to you, sir. Right. So, now I invite Shivani to please initiate her talk. Shivani?
Yes, sir. I'm present here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pranam to everyone. I would like to start my discussion. So first of all, we are going to discuss about Lord Rama and Krishna. So there are some preconditions for our discussion. I would like to explain them minutely. First, everybody who believes in Ram and Krishna has to believe in anthropomorphism, because in Hindu or Sanatan mythology, Lord Rama and Lord Krishna were the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Rama was the seventh and Krishna was the eighth. Lord Rama was born in Treta Yuga and Krishna in Dwapar. It has been assumed in our mythology, Hindu mythology, that Lord Vishnu takes incarnation in the earth when injustice increased too much by evil doers, and when life of religious people became difficult. So for the destructions of the evil doers, Ravan and Kansa, as also said in Bhagavad Gita, yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharatam abhyutthanas dharmasya tadanmanam sujanmaham. The incarnation happens. Here Krishna said in Bhagavad Gita that whenever there is a decline in religion practice, O descendant of Bharat, and a predominant rise of irreligion, at that time I descend myself. The concept of justice and public welfare is the main and important theme when we talk about Lord Rama and Lord Krishna. Both were the incarnation of Lord Vishnu, and they both am I audible, sir?
Yes, please go.
Yes,
ahead.
Sir. Yeah. So when we talk about Ramaraj or the concept of Ramaraj, that it was said that Ram, when we think about Ram, the image of ideal king came to our mind, to an ideal son who sacrifices her wife, life, his kingdom, a lot of things just to fulfill his father's promises and his duties. And it was said that there was no physical, spiritual and material sufferings in Ram Rajya. दैहिक दैविक भौतिक तापा राम राज्य का होने ही व्यापा. Lord Ram was the embodiment of an ideal king who did not avoid any established rule or maryada. That's why we call him Maryada Purushottam. So his whole life was a struggle for the establishment of ideal values. I think one example will be sufficient. Even after knowing the truth of Sitama, he was God, he was the incarnation of Lord Vishnu, he knows everything, that after knowing this fact that Sita had nothing to do with the blame depicted by the washerman, he sacrificed her only to establish a great value for the public opinion. As a king, for his kingdom, for the welfare of his pupils, it was important for him to give them respect and to value their opinion. So there is a quote I quoted it from a mythological book, that yadapi shuddham lok viruddham na kariniyam na karniyam. Even if you know that whatever you are doing is right, But if you are doing it against your pupil, against your pupil's opinion, sometime you should quiet or you should wait. You should wait for their opinion or their act. So when we talk about Lord Krishna, his image is different than Lord Rama. Both were incarnation of Lord Vishnu, but there are some similarities and differences between them. He was a flute player, a lover, a total different personality. So on the other hand, Krishna too had declared in Gita that aim of Krishna was to establish justice, and he did not hesitate to overrule the establishment tradition or values when he felt that it is necessary for public interest or in the favor of justice. As Krishna killed Kaliya, Kans, Satkasur and Pralamb. For example, we may also recall the prohibition of worshipping Indra. And during Mahabharata time, Krishna said that he will not use astra, he will not fight. But when he saw that Bhishma is against Pandavas, and to save Pandavas from him, he fought. He break his promise. So the basic difference between Ram and Krishna is that for public opinion, Ram sacrificed her wife. But Krishna has break his promises to save the pupils. And whenever Krishna enjoys his whole life, even in his struggle and in his life, we can say that if he combine together them, their values, then we can say that Ram is the champion of idealism, and where is the Krishna is the champion of diplomacy, values, and he depicts, he's the symbol of celebration of life. In our mythology, there was a scene, and if we believe that he was dancing on the head of Kaliya Nag, it shows the personality and the qualities of Lord Krishna. There are also some life lessons we can learn from them. From Ram, we can learn that never give up. It may take a day, weeks, or even years. When you fix onto a goal, never go back down. And there are a lot of qualities also, like we should always keep calm, obey, and respect our elders. And importance of friendship, like Ram's friendship is Sugriv and Vibhishan and monogamy at that time. And when we talk about Krishna, he also teaches us the lesson that we should struggle but never give up, and be generous, be humble, and protect women. Always raise your voice and protect women. And the duty, we should fulfill our duty towards our parents. When we have almost lost our traditional values, so for the reestablishment of ancient traditional, we have to follow, and we should have to do the ideas, the path shown by the establishment of Ram and Krishna for a better atmosphere, and to do justice with the pupil, and for good of ourselves, and for the welfare of our country, we should follow them. Ram and Krishna, they are similar, they are different, and they both were the incarnation of Lord Vishnu. Even then, they show different teaching lessons. They did everything for the justice. Their aim was the same, but the path, the way they showed to us was different. But we should follow them if we want peace, happiness, and prosperity around us. Thank you, sir.
Right, right. Exactly timed, Shivani. Thank you.
So this is my first international discussion, and I'm a bit nervous.
No, it's okay. But it's thank okay. You, sir, you spoke well. You spoke well. Excellently spoke. So a very simple question that comes to my mind is that when you say yada yada hi dharmas, so you see. When do we know as general people that the time has come that Lord would come to finish adharma? So भक्तों को कैसे पता चलता है, मतलब ये आपका इसके बारे में what do you have to say about this?
Yeah. Sir, as you know that we are already living in Kali Yuga, a lot of things are happening around us. So it's hard for us, for a normal people, to know that it is the time for God to take incarnation or do something. I don't have much idea about it, but I think the time will come. I don't know, sir. I have no idea.
Right.
That when I can get that, as you already know that we are living in Kali Yuga, so what can I say? I don't know.
Right, I get it.
Can I get your answer about it? Like,
no, same. I have the same feeling actually. So,
yes, sir, same,
you see,
same.
Your expression is much better than what I would have said actually. You see, that is the most important part. So, thank you. Thank you so much. So now I invite sir. There is one more speaker, and then so now I invite Srishti to please come and speak.
Hello, pranam everyone. सबको मैं बहुत बहुत प्रणाम करना चाहती हूँ एंड थैंक यू ओम सर फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. दिस इज माय आल्सो वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम स्पीकिंग इन सच फोरम एंड इट इज वेरी एनलाइटनिंग. आई जस्ट वांटेड टू स्टार्ट माय थिंग विथ कॉन्ग्रेचुलेटिंग एवरी वन ऑफ अस कि राम दोबारा वनवास से कलयुग में वापस आ गए हैं. 5 तारीख को वी हैव रीस्टैब्लिश्ड राम जन्मभूमि एज अयोध्या रामलला को हमने एस्टैब्लिश कर दिया है. विद दिस आई वांट टू स्टार्ट माय टॉपिक दैट द वे ऑफ वर्क लाइक राम एंड कृष्ण दे बोथ वर इनकार्नेटेड विष्णु एज इनकार्नेटेड एज राम एंड कृष्ण बट द वर्क स्टाइल वर कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट. सो आई वांट टू कनेक्ट दिस with the current situation where we have established or we have done the pujan of Ram Janmabhoomi again, we are now building the Ram Mandir again. So we needed a leader who is as good as Ram as well as Krishna, because Ram was Maryada Purushottam. He was the ethical warrior. He was a good learner. At the same time, the Krishna, he was the most intelligent diplomat of his times. So the both of these qualities were the actual need of, actually now is the actual need of time. So that is why we are really trying to establish our nation again as it used to be, the Sone Ki Chidiya. So taking the same aspects into Rama Yug, which is Treta, and Krishna Yug, which is Dwapar. Rama Yug, in Treta, people seems to be more ethical. They used to believe into the single leader. Because we know when Dashrath had no children, the people used to talk about it. People used to feel eager. They used to feel that they should have some person, they should continue their legacy, because they had that thing in their mind that I need someone, a ruler. We need one ruler in our constituency, in our nation, that will rule exactly like the way we were being ruled since years from Ikshvaku Vansh. So they had that belief in their leader. However, at the time of Krishna, there was no single leader. They were having so small regions. Our nation was divided into so smaller regions into Treta Yuga, and every one of them were fighting with each other to expand their constituencies. So this was the major difference in the mindset of the people that we can think, that I can descend up upon. That people were, most people were believer at the time of Rama Yuga, but at the time of Krishna, people used to believe in themselves. They wanted to fight, they wanted to rule, and they had their own opinion, maybe wrong or right. So Ram and Krishna were
different in thinking because Ram knew that people believe in me and I had to make such goals that my society should follow them and make a very good nation and a very good society. However, at the time of Krishna, he knew that there were so many rulers, there were so many thinkings that will descend slowly into the society and that will ruin the unity of the nation. So that is why Krishna's main objective was to make a singular ruler so that the same thinking can be given to the community, to the society. That was his objective. So he used to do everything. He was a quick action taker. He was the most diplomat person. He has to fight the thoughts of Shakuni. So he has to be smarter. So when I consider these two things of Ram and Krishna in modern times, then we have to perform, we in ourselves, to have that both traits of Ram and Krishna. We have to see that who we're talking to, who is our opponent, and that is how we should react.
Bas kitna baj gaya? Bas 15 minute bacha.
Sorry.
Kindly mute yourself. Yeah. Sorry. Yeah. Please go ahead. Yeah.
So that is how we should behave to the person or especially to the opponent, that if the person is smarter, then we should work smart. If the person who is our opponent is a hard worker, then we should be a warrior like a Ram, who always been a frontline warrior. So these were my points for the work aspect, that how we can, in the modern times, make our ideals. It is not just about having Ram as an ideal or Krishna as an ideal. When in a Kali Yuga, we face a lot of struggles, a lot of things that, you know, happening around us, including this pandemics and the mental traumas and psychological imbalances. We should take things from Rama's life and Krishna's life and adopt them as per the need of the hour, which was done correctly by Ram and Krishna. And to the question that sir asked, that when Krishna says yada yada hi dharmasya, so my thinking is when Krishna says ki jab bhi dharma ki hani hogi main janm lunga, agar hum is cheez ko is tarah se samjhe, no matter if the God is coming to our life or not, we can be our own God, our own protector. Better to say protector, not God. We cannot be God. We can be our own protector, especially at the time of this pandemic, when we are having a lot of psychological and mental traumas. We should be away from these problems. We should protect ourselves mentally. And we should fight it mentally, of course, when we can't do it physically. And we are not that capable of doing it. So just consider yourself as the protector and just believe in God that He's there to see you, to protect you, of course, over you. So this was it. I just wanted to put these basic points into this communication. I am very thankful that I have given this opportunity, and these Hegde sisters, these Akars, they have set a very good example, and I'm very much impressed that we are having this platform where every person is speaking and we are having all age groups in the single screen. So thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. So nicely timed and spoken, very well spoken. So now Sri Chaturvedi ji would ask his question, and then we will go for a common question after this. Yeah.
First of all, I would say that Chauve ji, the trusty Chauve, because we Chaturvedis are also called Chauve, basically. So that's the similarity is here. And the way you have described, you have picked the point from Dashrath ji, and all the surrounding. Can you briefly tell something about the Lord Rama and Krishna? How was their behavior towards their teachers? यहाँ पे ओम जी जैसे teacher, professor and the literate and doctors are here. तो दोनों का ही अपने गुरु के प्रति क्या आदर भाव था एंड व्हाट सिमिलरिटी एंड व्हाट डिफरेंसेस दे ऑप्टेड फॉर मींस फ्रॉम द बोथ बोथ ऑफ द दीस साइड्स.
Yes, thank you, sir, for asking this question. Actually, I skipped this point. I had this thing in mind. Ram was a continuous student, I would say. He was a continuous learner throughout his life. He had learned from Vashisht, then from Vishwamitra. And when he gone to exile, he started learning from all the scholars throughout the forest he met. So he took all the things, like whenever I say Rishi Munis, they were our scholars and researchers and scientists. So throughout his journey to the exile, he was learning things. Maybe it is about the fighting tactics or the weapons or the knowledge about the Shastras and Vedas, everything. He was a very good listener and he used to take knowledge from all the surroundings and the community and of course from the scholars. Whereas when I talk about Krishna, he was a good orator. He used to give his lessons to everyone. He took just 2 months hardly his lessons from Maharshi Sandipani. Otherwise, throughout his life, he has given his knowledge to the other people. He has given his quick wit. He has given his... Yes. He has given his knowledge to the people.
Very good. Well done. Thank you.
Excellent answer. So now there is a common question for all the participants. I'll ask this question.
And can I just say something?
Just a moment, sir. There's a question to be asked to everyone. After this, I'll hand it over to Om, sir, and he will take it further. Yeah. So, there's a common question for all the participants and they will answer this same question in the order they have presented. And they will take 40 seconds to 60 seconds for the answer. So please listen to this simple common question carefully and then start answering in your sequence. So, and if you want, I will call names after 40, 45 seconds for everyone to answer. So the common question is very simple.
Please wait. You know, he has requested you multiple times. Please wait. Today is a different format. These are all young kids presenting, and there's really not much opportunity for any of us to ask very many questions. Yes. Please wait. Thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you. Yeah.
So, very simple question. That who is your Isht amongst both between both of these lords, Sri Ram or Sri Krishna? And why? So simply answer this question on who is your Isht and why. Yeah, please go ahead. So first is Aparna to answer this question.
Sir, can you repeat the question?
Yeah. Who is your Isht, the whom you worship, Sri Ram or Sri Krishna, and why? So simply, So obviously in both of your cases, definitely one worships Krishna and one worships Ram, as we can decipher. But we want you to answer this later on as your turn comes in. So yeah, Aparna, please go ahead. Yeah.
This is a question. But yes, we definitely, if to answer this question, who is our East, then I must say, since the similarities and the similarities, the contrast was compared, so I found that Ram being the role model, the magnanimous, the Maryada Purushottam, the personality who led by example, was somebody who belonged to a world where there was less corruption, less despondency, less unruly people. Means more for the righteous and virtuous people. He is a character to be followed by more righteous and virtuous people. But in the true sense of Kali Yuga, and my Isht also is Lord Krishna, where I find him as a philosopher, as a smart diplomat. He's called Yog Purush, Leela Purushottam. And he is a person. He is a person who leads by objective, the management by objective. So he gives us more insight on how to deal with today's environment. So my Isht is Lord Krishna,
thank you, Aparna. Thanks. Thank you, sir. Now, Akarsh, please, would you like to go ahead with the answer, Akarsh? Akash, are you there? So we'll give Akash another chance once he comes back. In the meanwhile, Supriti, please go ahead with your answer.
Yes, sir. So I feel I would go with the option of Vishnu, who has both the characteristics of Lord Rama as well as Lord Krishna. Whereas I can't exactly choose between both of them, as they both set examples in very different ways, and for every phase of our life, we do find both of them guiding us with patience, intelligence, wisdom, or anything that might have taken as a part of their life. I say I would choose Lord Vishnu for that.
Okay, thank you. So now, Savitri, what do you have to say?
Me too. I would like to opt Lord Vishnu, in a sense, both Lord Rama and Lord Krishna, because both of them are two different personalities with some common characteristics. Both show us very different paths. While Lord Rama is a very person who actually brings us to a path where ideals become more important, and he shows us something while he does the same. But whereas Lord Krishna, he doesn't do things on his own, but does it from makes it from others. So here we can see that Lord Rama does the thing, and Lord Krishna does it through others. Guidance becomes more important here. So I would like to choose both.
Okay, thank you. So Garima, yeah, it's your turn now. Garima, are you there? Yeah.
Yes, sir. So I think I'll go with Lord Rama, because he personifies the characteristics of an ideal person. That's why he was called Purushottam. And he always lived his whole life by the rules of Dharma. And he was always the perfect son, the perfect husband, and always a good father to his kids. So I think I would go with Lord Rama, so I can learn a lot of good, traits from him.
Thank you. So Shivani, yeah. Please unmute yourself, Shivani, first.
Sir, my is Lord Krishna. Because we are living in Kali Yuga, and it's very hard for us to follow the path Ram has shown. So I would love to go with the path shown by Lord Krishna. And one thing that he's an influencer and he's a motivator, like he was the full incarnation of Lord Vishnu. He represents the 16 colors, like he was a dancer, a friend, lover, flute player. So I like, I worship Krishna more than Ram, and he's my
Thank you. So good.
And our life. Hello, sir. Can I speak?
Yeah. Please.
Even he gives us a lesson that even in the deepest sorrow, music of life cannot be stopped.
Okay. Great. Thank you, sir. So, Akash, have you come back? Akash, are you there? Okay. We'll go for Akash after Srishti. So, Srishti, it's your turn to answer. Yeah.
So for me, we live into a society where in our mandir we have minimum 60 or 80 devtas in the mandir. So for that thing, I cannot choose one as the East. And for sure, the devotion is equal for both Ram and Krishna. When we think about prem, love, we always want to be like Krishna. We want to spread so much of love for our loved ones. And when we talk about our duties and morality, then we seek our blessings from Rama. When I wanted to do some duties, I want to be like him. I want to do my duties exactly the way Ram and Sita did. So the East cannot be one for me, for sure. So I want to follow both of them.
Right. Okay. Thank you. So nicely answered. We'll just call for Akarsh once again. Akarsh, are you there?
Ji, sorry, we had some
No. It's perfectly all right. Akarsh, there is a question for a common question for everyone. I'll repeat it for you.
Ji.
So, who is your Isht, Sri Ram or Sri Krishna, and why?
I think my Isht would be Sri Krishna Ji, because the stories I have listened about and the things I have watched on YouTube and my parents have told me, all I've heard about him being a small child and Ramji being a big adult who had to fight his and overcome his problems when he was older. But as Sri Krishna relates to me when I'm young, I think I could look up to him as I could follow in his tracks and...
Right. And thank you so much. Thank you, Akarsh. So nice. So I thank all the speakers. Thank you so much for so beautiful presentations and beautiful answers given to everyone. And now I hand over back to sir for the closing remarks and finishing of today's session. Sir.
Okay. Thank you. Everyone. I don't know where do I start from. If I start thanking, then half an hour will go in that. So let me, I know Tiraj ji is very anxious to talk, so I'll definitely call him, but please have some patience, sir. See, today...
Okay, I'll start?
No, sir, I will call you. I'll invite you, sir. Please mute yourself right now.
Okay.
So today we had invited seven young and youth attendance. Everybody showed up. The average age of presenters today is 21 years. And I mean, I learned so many things. I can't believe it, you know. And my God, you know, they are our future. You know, we should give hope. So this will continue next week. There will be six presenters next week. And so please do come. And I want to thank all of you who have come here to listen. I was, honestly speaking, very concerned about today's attendance. That ये बच्चों के पास कौन अपना जगह टाइम वेस्ट करेगा छोड़ो यार यू नो तो मुझे तो इसलिए आना पड़ता है कि यू नो नहीं आऊंगा तो आप तो सब लोग पकड़ के मेरे को जीते मारोगे पर आप सब लोग आए आई मीन 75 प्लस पीपल आर अटेंडिंग टुडेस प्रोग्राम व्हिच इज नॉट अ रिकॉर्ड फॉर अस बट सर्टेनली इन रिसेंट टाइम्स आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी गुड अटेंडेंस एंड आई एम सेइंग दैट अगेन टू अप्रिशिएट द एनकरेजमेंट दैट यू आर गिविंग please turn off your there are some people have their things on, so that's why all this noise is coming. Seriously, aapka hi on hai. Ye pata nahi kahan se aawaz aa rahi hai. I would like to have your suggestions, not today, later on by WhatsApp message or by email, what kind of activities we should be doing which will be attracting children and youth for this kinds of things, you know, for religious, you may call it, or spiritual, you may call it, or adhyatmic. So I personally would like to do more and more of such things where we have engagement with younger people rather than people of my age, you know. I want to be out. I want people in... teenagers, you know, this boy is 12 years old, you know, not even teenagers. So let young people, teenagers in their 20s or even 30s be active. So send me your suggestions. You know, you can call me, you can WhatsApp me, you can email me, you can come my home. Of course, in the corona times, you may not want to do that. So all these things can be done. So thank you all, young people. All have done excellent job. I learned from everybody, you know. I can't rule out that this person I didn't learn anything from. Our panel who is sitting here, Vinayji, Chakravartiji, and Saitiji, very interesting question. The last question you asked me baffled me. So you asked me that question, who is your, and I would have hard time saying, even I know Ram is more of my Ishtadev, but I would not be saying it publicly, you know. Some of these Krishna people will beat me up. So, but it's a very tough question to answer. And look how these guys can become good politicians, you know, how they answer these questions. amazing. They've learned a lot of things from Krishna, obviously. So let me now CSG को बोल बोल रहा हमारे बड़े मित्र हैं यूस्टर में रहते हैं तो
yes thank you I will be very brief thank you very much you know that the subject given to the children was very nice but in that one I want to say that Krishna and Ram they were in different times they were in under different circumstances so all that was different so if they were given the subject to compare that is good but all these differences both sides and all of them they gave is just importance or mahatva of hamare avatars Krishna and Ram and that one definitely Srishti ji has explained in very details which I have not been able to say now but she has compared that both of these we should have in us and the protection of at the last question when she answered that we have to be our own protector not to wait for Krishna to take his avatar and thank you
all very good very good comment anybody else I think we'll take maybe thank another 10 minutes for your comments yes Asha ji please
I will say a great applause for our all young speakers and today's session as you were saying that some people might be thinking not come I will say in 18 sessions today's session was the one of the best sessions and we learned a lot from our young generation great knowledge big depth and the girls were speaking and Akash you all are so amazing you touched our heart and we all have to learn from our young generation and mera bahut bahut naman to Dr. Sharma Vinay Sharma who selected them it is a great thing and great promise and great hope for our bright future aap sabko bahut bahut naman speakers ko bhi and please young generation ek choti si iltizaa choti si binti hai ki aap jahan bhi hain अपने यंगर लोगों को भी गाइड कीजिए वो आपसे ज्यादा सुनेंगे इंस्टेड ऑफ अपने पेरेंट्स के तो अपने चारों ओर के लोगों को भी दिशा प्रदान करें बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद
उषा जी प्लीज गो अहेड
तो वन ऑफ द स्पीकर्स एंड आई एम सॉरी डोंट नो द नेम शी मेड एन एक्सलेंट पॉइंट कि हमें इष्ट पहली बात तो मेरी अंबल प्रार्थना ये है कि ये प्रश्न वाज नॉट अप्रोप्रिएट किसी का इष्ट पूछना इज नॉट ए वेरी विधान के अनुसार इट्स नॉट अ वेरी अप्रोप्रिएट क्वेश्चन बट इट जनरेटेड अ लॉट ऑफ थॉट इन दीज पीपल एंड फ्रॉम दैट पर्सपेक्टिव इट वाज गुड इट वाज आई एम परफेक्टली फाइन विद व्हाट गॉड सेड बट देयर वाज समथिंग दैट गॉड सेड व्हिच वाज कि गीता में कृष्ण जी ने ये देख लिया था द्वापर में कि अब कलयुग आने वाला है और कलयुग में न केवल कर्म योग से काम चलेगा न केवल धर्म योग से काम चलेगा कलयुग के जो लोग हैं ना उनके लिए कुछ बताना ही पड़ेगा तो इसीलिए उन्होंने गीता के जो लास्ट 6 चैप्टर्स हैं जो कि ज्ञान योग पर फोकस करते हैं गुह्यतम उसको अपना गुह्यतम संदेश कहा है और गुह्यतम संदेश में उन्होंने आत्मा को पहचानने की इंडिविजुअल को खुद ब्रह्मत्व पहचानने की जहां इष्ट की आवश्यकता नहीं होती तो हमें राम और कृष्ण को अपने सांसों में लाना है राम मेरे सांस हैं और कृष्ण मेरी आस हैं ये बिहारी बापू अक्सर कहा करते हैं और इन दोनों को मिलके हमें ब्रह्मत्व अपने में अनुभव करना है So that's the message I want to give, which was very nicely directed by one of the speakers. Hats off. It was the most amazing session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Didi, for your comment. Yeah, Haji, Dr. Bole. Bole, Dr.
Sir, may I say?
Haan, Bole.
Sir, a small comment hai from this today's event. we can change our opinion actually we need not look at our seniors only to learn
yes,
most of our younger generation, whom we think we will make learn something, they are more learned and we have to learn many things from them. That is my quick comment from this event.
Okay, very nice. Thank you. हाँ बोलिए बोलिए मिश्रा जी.
Both Ram and Krishna are present in their holy names. Krishna means attractive, Ram means pleasant, and in present age Kali Yuga, name is the only foundation. Both are non-different.
Thank you. So I think it may be time to close. Let me just give you what's up coming up. So next week on 11th, when that is Janmashtami, we will have a bhajan program here, just like we had last week on 5th August. There are already, I think, 25 some people signed up for that. So I'll be finalizing that list and sending to them. Next, that will be Tuesday, same time. On 15th of August, we will continue the same program. There will be six youths will be speaking on the same topic. After that, on 22nd August, we will have our usual format with four speakers. They'll be talking about Gita in Manas. As I said, you know, August, we are doing things, you know, around Lord Krishna and his pastime and things like that. And we have one extra Saturday this month in August, on 29th August, will be a small workshop here on how to read Ramcharitmanas correctly or accurately. Many of us are reading, we have seen in Mass Parayan, in Akhand Path, and Sundarkan and all that. So some have some little difficulty reading because of pronunciation and all that. So we'll talk about it, that what are the common errors, how do we fix that. So again, there's a Google form, you all have it. And don't have, let me know if you want to join that session, you sign up for that. Moving on, September, I will not talk right now, but I'll just mention about October. We have earlier discussed that during Navratra, which is from what date? Somewhere 17th to 24th October, 9 days. We'll be celebrating a global Ram Mahotsav for 9 days. And I've said, like, look, don't tell me anything right now. Keep thinking what can be done. So, but don't write anything to me right now. So now I will create a separate WhatsApp group for that. Those who are interested in taking active role in that, those who enroll that. So other people should not enroll. Active role in the sense of, you know, they will participate in some way or contribute in some way or whatever. So then what do we do those 9 days? So for 9 days, we definitely, one thing we are going to do is in our Ramcharitmanas part. So about 4 hours, we'll go in there. Last day on Vijayadashmi Day, my vision is, my thought is, for 24 hours, we have a online program on something related with Ramji or Ram Mahotsav globally. So what can be done, which is useful, entertaining in the sense that, you know, spiritually enlightening and things like that. So uske jo bhi suggestions ho, abhi maine aap sabko mana kiya ki don't write anything because so many things are going on, it will get lost. But now I'll open up that and you send your suggestions there. So all these things are coming up, and so much interest and so much excitement with everybody. So that's so kind of you. I'm so happy. So thank you. Thank you very much. And with that, I think we'll close today's meeting with some closing prayer. Please join me if you can. Om Sarvesham Swastir Bhavatu. Sarvesham Shantir Bhavatu. Sarvesham Purnam Bhavatu. Sarvesham Mangalam Bhavatu. Sarve Bhavintu Sukhina. Sarve Santu Niramaya. Sarve Bhavintu Prashantu. Mahaschit Dukshagbhave. Om Vasato Maha Sadhamaya. Samto Mani Jyotirgamaya. Asyo. Om Namah.